Islam needs a reboot, and that's the word from Egypt's president, El-Sisi. It's the second time in 3 weeks he's called for a revolution in Islam.
El-Sisi was speaking at the World Economic Forum in Switzerland, where he warned Western leaders about the dangers of Islamic terrorism. Chris Mitchell brings us the story.
El-Sisi continued his campaign to change the image of Islam. He said Muslims must seek change from within and remove the things that lead to violence and extremism. Several weeks earlier, El-Sisi addressed Islam's most influential university and called for a revolution in Islam.
It has reached the point that this ideology is hostile to the entire world. Is it conceivable that 1.6 billion would kill the world's population of 7 billion so that they could live on their own? Let me say it again. We need to revolutionize our religion.
Sisi's speech highlighted an important debate going on inside Islam between those who want a more moderate Islam and groups like ISIS. The debate accelerated when ISIS began its brutal campaign.
According to the Quran and the Hadith, is exactly what ISIS is doing. Like in the time of Muhammad, the prophet.
Former Israeli ambassador to Egypt, Zvi Mazel, says Sisi's speech to some of the foremost scholars in the Muslim world was unprecedented.
But here you have a president, the president of Egypt, the most important country in the Arab world. And he's telling them in their faces, listen, guys, you have to change.
And Sisi is not alone.
It's not just him. The king of Jordan, King Abdullah II, has taken the exact same approach, and actually over several years now, working both with moderate Muslim leaders to make theological statements and build a consensus, not just in Jordan, but throughout the Muslim world, that radical Islam is not the Islam that that most Muslims want to practice.
It's unclear if the actions of these men will make any difference without help.
It's a battle right now for the soul of Islam. And the West needs to be encouraging, supporting, assisting any leader in the Muslim world who takes a proactive, moderate position.
Without that support, Islam could split into two directions, one that spreads terror as in Paris, and another that tries to make peace with itself and the world. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.
Well, I wish him well, but the last time a president of Egypt tried to call for moderation, his name was Anwar Sadat, and he made peace with Israel. And the Muslim Brotherhood said that that was unacceptable, and they ended up assassinating him very publicly. So we need to pray for his protection, but also realize he's walking the walk here. For the first time in the history of the Republic of Egypt, a president has gone to a mass at a Coptic church, and he was the one that did it. So he's trying to walk the walk as well as talk about revolution. He's trying to bring it. Well, the call for revolution in Islam comes as one of the most important leaders in the Muslim world has died. Ephraim Graham has that story from the CBN newsroom. Ephraim?
Gordon, Saudi Arabian King Abdullah died at age 90, had been an ally of the United States on some key issues. He worked aggressively to stop the spreading power of Iran. Abdullah even urged Washington in 2008 to consider military action against Iran because of its nuclear program. But he was also unhappy with the U.S. because of a lack of progress in peace talks between the Arabs and Palestinians. The new king, Abdullah's 79-year-old half-brother, also has some health concerns. He's already named a Saudi minister to succeed him as the new king when he's gone. Nagme Abedini, the wife of Pastor Saeed Abedini, who's in prison in Iran, tells CBN News her meeting with President Obama Wednesday in Boise, Idaho, was an answer to prayer. She says she told the president she's praying for him, and he gave her some contacts and some steps to take to help get her husband out of prison. She says she'll be following up on those steps, and she'll keep praying and fasting.
I want to see God get glorified in Saeed's release. Like, this meeting, everyone will say, this was a God thing. Why did Obama come to Boise? Or, you know, just Saeed's release, I'm praying for the same thing, that it would be evident to the whole world that Jesus Christ is Lord, and he's alive, and he has the world in his hands, and we can pray, and he will listen.
Nagme also talked about the hardships her husband is facing in prison in Iran.
He still suffers. He still has a lot of pain. Of course, he's in one of the worst prisons in the world. The nutrition is horrible. The conditions are horrible. And we're just praying that he doesn't have to sit there very long. He's been in that prison long enough, over 2.5 years. And we're praying that that time is coming to an end and we can bring him home.
You can see Nagmay's full interview at cbnnews.com.